This is Kazan with Spellbinders. Today's project is going to be to create this bezel charm with a little anchor metal embellishment to match this already purchased and pre-made necklace. So this is a great way to really make your jewelry piece unique and original, and all with Spellbinders bezels and some ice resin. Let me show you how. I'm going to start off with my Spellbinders bezel, and these were created to either use by itself or with a pocket to fill with ice resin. Spellbinders has the matching die templates that allow us to cut shapes to perfectly fit each bezel. I'm going to use the middle die template for this bezel. I like the gold, and Spellbinders bezels are a little bit more of a bronzy color. So to get the gold to match my necklace, I simply colored it in with a metallic marker like that. And it really gives it a sort of an authentic gold tarnished look, which looks really nice with this particular jewelry piece. Now to complete my charm, I need to fill it with paper. Spellbinders also has this wonderful pad of paper called ephemera paper. Lots of different designs and scripts. But the paper is a little thin and it may look a little cloudy. So the best thing to do is adhere the paper to some cardstock. And I like to seal it on both sides. So I'm simply going to adhere it to the cardstock with a layer of Mod Podge. And you just need a small piece for this particular size bezel. So I'm just going to add some Mod Podge to my cardstock, my paintbrush. And then I'm going to just adhere my paper to the top of that. And then seal it with another layer of Mod Podge. Just a thin layer, it's going to dry nice and clear. But this is going to give my paper that extra pop once I add the ice resin to it. There we go. I'm going to let that dry for a few minutes and then we can cut it out. Okay, our paper's nice and dry. So now I can position my die template. And because I can see through the die template, I can find the exact spot for the image or script that I want. I'm just going to secure that down with some tape and position that on my base plate A of my Artisan Explorer machine. Be sure to have the cut side up. There we go. And then cover that with my cutting plate C and run the sandwich through my machine. All right, let's take a look. This came out great, cut perfectly through. And now I have a perfectly cut square shape to fit right inside my square bezel. No trimming, no fussing. And now I'm ready to embellish with my charm and my little bits of bling. Once we've completed our embellishments of our bezel, we can fill it with ice resin. Be sure to follow the manufacturer's directions to a T when it comes to mixing and drying time for the ice resin. And once all's complete, you're left with a beautiful custom-made charm. Thanks for joining me and happy crafting.